Hey guys, Brooke Whipple here. Welcome to my channel. You probably wonder what I'm talking about with that thumbnail, but today I walked into my job and I quit just like that. Today I was done with this job. Absolutely nothing wrong with any kind of work. Puts food on the table, puts money in my pocket, but at the same time, working that job makes me sacrifice all the other stuff that I'm truly passionate about in life. All the stuff that I want to do to move forward, to advance, to make a difference, to impact people. And it was really weighing on me today. I mean, I was just so miserable at work. I was just so unhappy to be there. You just have those days when you're just completely done. And I reached that point today because there was so much here at home that I wanted to do. Guys, I am done working for other people. I want to change and impact other people's lives. I want to inspire people. I want them to get outside and get happy, like I always say. But more than that, each and every one of us has a special skill, has special abilities and talents that we should be chasing down. That is what we should be doing with our lives. I know we have to pay the bills in the meantime, but today is the day I'm laying it all on the table. I'm willing to take a risk today with that, because when you put everything on the line, it gets real and you have no choice other than to succeed. So the past couple weeks, I've been revamping a new website. I've been thinking about wilderness classes and skills classes. I want to go into schools and speak. I want to speak at events. I want to inspire people to be the best that they can be, to rise up to meet their life. That's what gets me jazzed, you know? And so when I came to work this morning and I'm just plugging away, making somebody else's dream a reality, it is soul-sucking. And I know so many of you are in the same spot, right? You're at a job that you hate. And you're locked in because you've got bills and you've got obligations. I know the feeling. And you may think, well, you know, once you get on TV and you do some of these things, oh, it's easy. No, nobody comes knocking down your door and pays your bills. The TV shows, they pay while you're on that gig. And just like anything else, when the gig's over, the money stops. It's a blessing to go and do something and get paid to do something you love. But there's a point in time when it's over. So I'm challenging you today. What is it in your life that you need to address? What is holding you back from really taking that leap off the cliff, taking that dive to jump into the unknown, to do something risky, to say, I'm going to put it all on the line because it's important and I want to chase this down. That's where I'm at today. Whew. I've got plans, I've got ideas, I've got ambitions, and when I'm working for someone else, I feel like I'm just in quicksand. I feel like I'm just slowly sinking, and the soul and the life is being ripped out of me. So I'm done. It's sink or swim today. I've got to make it on my own. I got to put the money in my own pocket, making it my own way, which I'm so ready to do. I'm so ready to just, you know, when you've worked for yourself for a while, if you've ever left a job and worked for yourself, it is so hard to go back. It's so hard to go back and work for somebody else. You know, this world is just an amazing place, filled with amazing people, full of ideas. And I am definitely one of those idea people. I mean, I have so many ideas all the time. I mean, think about all those crazy cat t-shirts. I mean, somebody at one point said, I've got this idea. I'm going to put a cat in space riding a slice of pizza with the Milky Way behind it, and people are going to buy that shirt. And you know what? I'm one of those people. I own like 10 crazy cat shirts. I think they're fabulous. Somebody had that idea and chased it down. Anymore, when I say, I've got an idea, my husband's eyes just kind of roll back in his head. And thank goodness he's there to rein me in, because, I mean, I need somebody to say, no, that's a little bit too much out there, too far out there, you know what I mean? I mean, just in the past week, let me tell you, these are some honest to goodness things that I've thought about. Making whirly gigs, sewing backpacks, spear fishing, gas powered bicycles, rickshaws, how to train a chicken. And then I've got this idea for like static line mountaintop parachuting, where you like tether yourself to a really windy ridge top and you can just kind of let the line out and you're parachuting up there. Hey, and hope you're subscribed to my YouTube channel right here, because you never know, I might make that one a reality. That's in my head. Making sauerkraut, weaving cattails, making homemade wine. I've got a ton of grapes and blackberries. I'm gonna get into that. Do-it-yourself screen printing, how to sell on Etsy, cracking the code for homemade ding-dongs, training your dog to be a star. But of course, my dog's already a star. You guys know Maisie. She's back here. Writing young adult fiction. Tiny houses on wheels. This is, you don't want in here. Trust me, you don't want in here. This is the stuff that keeps me up at night. I just have ideas upon ideas upon ideas all the time. I mean, this world is just too darn interesting not to participate in. And lest you think I'm just a dreamer, I've turned lots of ideas into realizations. I've turned it into jobs. I've turned it into a lifestyle, really. We ended up on TV because we chose to be our true unique selves and surround ourselves with amazing people. And when you do that, amazing things happen. There is real power in just being you. I mean, why else would I be wearing weasel tails in my ears? Because hawk feathers are illegal. A lot of people I know are not happy. They're not participating. They've settled, they're still settling. They figure once they get all their ducks in a row, once they get the right job, once they get the right boyfriend, girlfriend, once they get the right marriage, once they get the right house, once they've saved enough money, then everything is gonna smooth over. Here's the big one. They're gonna save up and dream big, and when they retire, it's party time. That's when they're gonna live it up. And you know what happens? They do all that, they save it up, they save up their life, then they retire, boom, heart attack, die, gone. Their money's gonna go to their kids, their dreams are dying with them. That is so sad. Don't wait. Why are you waiting? I think of these people as the someday crowd. Someday, when I've got all this blah, 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 fill in the blank, then I'm gonna that's when I'm gonna be happy and it's all gonna come together. Then there's a whole bunch of people who would tell you all things they wish they could do or the things they want to do, right? Like, I wanna write a book. I wanna travel. I wanna learn to play the guitar. I wish I could start my own business. And you look into their eyes and you really look and you know they're not gonna do those things. That's like the I wish crowd. Then there's the people who just wanna blame everyone else for their unhappiness. They've resigned themselves to victimhood. And they're content to wallow in their circumstances instead of rising above it, right? We all know people like this. They would much rather blame someone else for their circumstances and their reality. And you know, this is the saddest group of people of all. This is like the I can't crowd. I can't because fill in the blank, somebody did this thing to me. This is what I lived through. This is what I'm going through. I can't. So I'm gonna ask you, what about you? Do you wake up excited and happy and engaged and pumped every day to do the thing that you were born to do? Or have you settled and you're letting your dreams slip away a little bit more every day, waiting for the right moment to come along to start? Well, I'll tell you what, nobody knows what tomorrow might bring. We just found out that a neighbor passed away, bam, just like that, massive heart attack the other day. He's gone. Here's the bottom line. You only got one shot at this. Do you want to be happy? I've got the solution, and it's gonna make all of the psychologists and psychiatrists and scholars and professors, it's gonna make everybody mad because it's so stupid simple, anybody can do this. Are you ready? Here it is. Shut up and do something. Do something drastic. Do something right now. Don't wait. Just like I did today. I was completely just done. So I quit. What about you? What are you gonna do today to start living your dream? To start moving the ball forward? To start to be really happy? I know there is something that you've been wanting to do for a long time. What is that? But you're like, I don't have the money, I don't have time, this isn't the right moment, I've got this going on, I've got that. Shut up and do something. No matter what excuse you give me, I'm going to tell you to shut up and do something, because failure is not an option. When you jump off that cliff, you have to make it work. That's when it gets real. That's the point you have to get to make things happen. And at that point, failure is not an option, because you have everything on the line. Humans are incredibly resourceful, resilient, and strong. You are capable of so much more than you think you are. So much more. You just have to believe in yourself. Sometimes you got to test yourself to find that out. And that's where standing on the cliff and jumping into the water, that's where the rubber meets the road. And the thing is, there's real power in just being you, doing the things that God designed you to do, the things that you're good at, the things that no one else is good at, just you. It's unique to you. You just have to believe in yourself. So that's my news today, guys. I quit my job. I'm making the leap to full-time YouTube, more videos, full-time teaching, full-time speaking. So here's my big plans, guys. I just did a whole new website. It's brookwhipple.com. It's got, I want to be a full-time speaker. I want to be a full-time teacher. And I'm going to make it happen. I have to make it happen now, because I quit today. I quit. Game on. I'm ready to do this. So go to my website. I've got a new women's workshop coming up. It's a one-day gig. It's here in Michigan. And gonna learn about survival shelters, starting fires, survival psychology, finding water, tactics. You know, it's just gonna be kind of a fun day. Bring your own skills to share too. And you can find out about that on my website, brookwhipple.com. Go to the events page. And then there's the speaking thing, guys. I want to be a speaker full-time. I've dabbled a little bit, but now I want to jump in full-time. I want to go into schools. I want to go to events. I want to inspire people that the coolest thing you can do is be yourself. That's where the magic lies. That is your superpower. When you figure out what you're truly, genuinely meant to be doing with your life, and you focus on that, bam! Like, amazing things will happen. I'm living proof. If you want to help me out, go to my website, check out www.brookwhipple.com. You'll find my page about speaking. I especially want to go into schools and speak to youth and inspire youth to be the best they can be and find their unique self before they get caught up like adults do in finding the perfect job based on a guaranteed position with a guaranteed pay with a 401k and blah-de-blah-de-blah, you know, $35,000 worth of student loan debt, chasing a job that is just all about the money. And I don't think life should be like that. I think you should do something because it's your passion and it's your skill and it's your unique abilities and your unique self. I always like to say that I'm kind of a little bit weird, and that to me has been almost like a superpower. Like, it has gotten me noticed because I'm not normal. Yeah, I'm definitely a little weird. I'd rather be weird, because the opposite of weird, guys, is normal. I don't want to be normal. I chase things down. I'm animated, you know. I'm me. I'm girl in the woods. And everyone is unique. And if you tap into those unique powers, I call them a superpower. Being you is your superpower. That will take you far. So I'm committed to doing my thing, speaking, teaching, full time, doing my artsy craftsy stuff. I don't know. It'll happen. It's gonna be fun. It's gonna be exciting. And I'm committed because I have to be. I gotta put money in my pocket. I gotta put food on the table. That is the message I wanna give youth. It's the message I wanna give adults. I wanna inspire. I got so much I want to do. So go to my website and support those things I got going on. So if you know a school or an event coming up and they need an inspirational, motivational speaker, go check out my website. I do have references. I've done a bit of this. I'm ready to dive in full time. I have to. What is it about you? What are you doing? I want to hear about it. Leave your comments below. That's all I have today, guys. Thanks so much for listening to my rant, my long rant. All right. I gotta go, it's getting dark, and I got a fire I'm gonna go sit by. Now get out and, you know, shut up and do something. That's all for me. This is Girl in the Woods. She gone. Oh, and don't forget to get outside and get happy. That was kind of long-winded. I get excited sometimes.